Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Explorers of Sky. In the last episode, we were looking for the hidden land, and we found it! Here it is! Right here. It's now the found land. And we're gonna go through it, and we're gonna die many times, because this level is very difficult. And we only have 2 Reviver Seeds with us. I've only bought 2 with us. Maybe that's a bad idea. But, I have only, like, 4 or 5 more in the storage after that. So, this may be very difficult. I'm not gonna lie. This may be very, very difficult. I'm gonna have to be very, very, not shy to use other healing items when the time arrives. Like, for example, I killed him. Killed a Rampardos in 1 hit. That's actually very surprising. Like, if I get slightly hurt, Oranberry, instantly. Oh, hey, stairs. I mean, I could fight these guys, but, like, why would I fight a dragon and a Garchomp and an Electric if I don't have to? Anyway, also, I realized I didn't fully explain something during last episode, but I probably, at this point, I would have edited it and added what I was going to say. Basically, I was giving options for, no damage. Why did you take no damage? Okay. What is going on? Whatever. I'm gonna eat, like, for example, I would eat an orange berry right now because I cannot be shy with items like this. Oh, we gotta use another. Oh, wait a minute. You should have used water gun or mud or water pulse in that moment right there, but you didn't. Another orange berry. I have plenty of orange berries. No question there. I can use those all day. I can use those all day. Revivers you don't have to worry about. I was giving options for what I'm going to do after this playthrough is done. The first option is nothing until sunrise, of course, and who knows how long that'll be. Second option is re-upload stream playthroughs, and I gave a few examples of what those would be. And the third option, which I didn't actually say, but I probably said in an edited annotation or note or something, something new. A new playthrough, like, the, you know, another playthrough recorded for YouTube. The problem with that option, though, is I may run into the same problem I ran into here, where I have too many things I'm doing at one time, and one thing will have to suffer, and chances are it will be the YouTube playthrough, just based on very clear evidence. And also, I'm going to eat this orange gummy, because you might think, oh, I should go back and turn it to juice. When will I do that? This is the end of the game. I confirmed I'm not doing post-game anymore, unfortunately. I apologize for those that wanted to see it, but, it's also been made clear that, me being frustrated at games is not good, is not enjoyable. You can actually learn Vacuum Cut? Really? Hits all enemies in the room. Yes, Dinsai, I'd like you to learn that. Thank you very much. What should I get? Oh, Tackle. We don't need Tackle anymore. We're gonna get Tackle. Forget Tackle. Yes. Thank you. I did not know Dinsai could learn Vacuum Cut. Wow. That's a really good move. I'm gonna turn it off right now, though. I'm gonna save it for Monster Houses. Yeah, it's a group attack. A Stay Away Orb. Stay Away Orb! Quick Attack, and he's gonna use a Quick Attack too, right? Yep. Yeah. New playthrough. What would the new playthrough be? I have a couple ideas. I don't really know for sure yet. My biggest idea would be XD Gale of Darkness. For a Pokemon playthrough, that is. That's, like, one of the only few Pokemon games I haven't played yet on the channel. I could do another spin-off, but I don't actually own any others. Unless you want to see a different Mystery Dungeon game, but like I've said a million times for this playthrough, I don't enjoy the other ones as much. A food item went bad. Did I tell you about the traps that make items in your pocket go bad? Well, yeah, I just lost my one big apple I brought. That's it. I only brought one because I was like, how often does hunger actually strike? Very, very rarely. And another gummy. I guess I'm eating gummies. And that actually restores hunger, so. And we learned Weak-type Picker. What does that even do? I don't think it matters, but I want to know anyway. Oh, weak type picker. Your server will target the one that has a type disadvantage. So something that doesn't affect me because I pick what I want to do. Oh, more traps. Cool. Thanks. Oh, Bastiodon. You got this, didn't I? Take that. Nice job. Bastiodon sucks. Anyway. Yeah, the XD Galadarkers are different, but I don't own any other spin-off games except the Mystery Dungeon games. I don't really enjoy the other Mystery Dungeon games that much, though. Except Blue. Blue and Red Rescue Team. I played Blue Rescue Team. They're the same game, but I only played that game once. I don't remember much about it, except I do remember I enjoyed it, to an extent, at the very least. So, I wouldn't mind doing that again. We're gonna use a facade. Well, that one-shot you, it did not one-shot you, unfortunately. But, yeah, darn. Okay. I don't know if facade was a great idea teaching, because I feel like I'm never using it. It's slightly stronger than tackle, there's no question there. But, oh well. And it's hailing now. Hello, Tropius. Hey, you got water pulsed. Take that. Yeah. Another playthrough idea? This is gonna sound really random at first. Undertale. Now, like, oh my god! Really, that game? Millions of people have played that game! It's super overrated and... Okay, do you remember my top 10 games of all time video? I'm still working on playing every game on that list. And spoiler, that's on that list. So, I'm gonna play it eventually. And I've already done many games from that list on my, oh my god, that was lucky. On live streaming and Blue Gritty Gaming as well. And also both. Like a lot of the ones I've been doing on streams, I've been re-uploading to Blue Gritty Gaming. Some examples are Kingdom Hearts, Dark Cloud 2, which is what I'm doing currently. We also did Zelda Minish Cap a while ago. We did Bleed and Bleed 2. That was literally one video, because it's a very short game. What else did we do? Oh, there's one I'm forgetting that we did. I know for sure we did. Oh, Fire Emblem Echoes. Yeah, we did that. All of those are on Blue Gritty Gaming, for those that don't know and want to see those. Undertale, I don't want to be a stream, though, because there's some things I want to do with it that I feel like I wouldn't be able to do very well with a stream. I don't want to reveal what those are without, because it would spoil some, I don't know, the surprise of what I feel like. I'm going to try to do something unique with it. We'll see if it's a good idea or not. So I want to do that at some point. I don't know if I want to do that next, though, because, you know, part of me thinks I should focus on Sunrise and save that for another time, which is understandable. That's a totally understandable thought to have. Bullet Seed. That'd be a great move if someone could learn it, but I'm pretty sure none of us can. Yeah, none of us can learn it. Darn. Okay. You know what? Maybe I should have taught myself Vacuum Cut. No, you know, it's okay. Wow, nice. Ancient Power. That attacks from the side. That's fine. Didn't I? You can attack from the side as well, can't you? That 41, that's not enough to kill you. That, another Ancient Power. Have an Auron buried, Dinsai. There you go, have an Auron berry. And you didn't need to use Water Pulse in those moments there. You could use Water Gun, but that's alright. Should I use an armor on myself? No, I'll just wait by the stairs for a little bit. Okay, now we can go. Now we're fine. Oh, hey, Garchomp, hello! Take that! And that, also, did I mention Grovyle is actually really helpful? It's kind of disappointing we don't get to use him for Temporal Tower, because, yeah, spoiler, he's not with us anymore. After that, we haven't seen why. I didn't tell you why. So, yeah, that's an option for a thing. Oh, Grovyle, you weren't supposed to walk there! I wanted Dinsai to fight it! Oh, boy. Oh boy. Uh-oh. Have a facade. Dig. Oh, well, that will one-shot him. I'm gonna walk this way. Boom. Goodbye. Yeah. So, yeah, that's the play that I'm gonna do at some... Undertale. It's the play that I'm gonna do at some point. I just don't know if I want to do it next. Aqua Tail. Okay. Grovile Dig, yeah. That'll one-shot him. I'll just go onto the stairs. Let's wait here and heal a little bit. Done. Perugly. You sure are ugly. Take that. Ooh, we got a sinister box! We're never, ever gonna know what's inside that because because this is the end of the game. I have a great gummy. We're gonna feed that to Dinsai. I already fed myself the other ones. Maybe Dinsai will grow an IQ level. He did! Type advantage master! So you're telling me he's now, at this point in the game! Get this, guys. At this point in the game! Oh, his critical hit rate is boosted when attacking enemies that have a type disadvantage. Okay, I thought it was gonna be like, he will now use attacks that are super effective against Pokemon if they are super effective. Oh, hey, an apple! I'll swap that with my grimy food. Oh, actually, I'll just pick it up. Never mind. I don't need to get rid of the grimy food yet. It's a Bastiodon. I know Dinsai couldn't fight him by himself. Oh, wait, I didn't mean to use Helping Hand. I meant to use Quick Attack. Oh, well. This will still be helpful. Yay! Level 34. We're going to need as many levels as we can because each level sucks. Somehow we got two in the defense categories. Defense and special defense. I'm not sure how that happened for a level up, but I'm not going to complain. Uh-oh, I have a bad feeling about this room. No? We're fine? No? Okay. Let's pick up these items. A joy ribbon. What is that? Converts damage into experience? That earns movement experience points when taking damage? No. I'm not. That I can see the idea. I can see the appeal. But no. And I might need an Oran Berry soon. Because this hail is preventing us from healing by waiting. Hey, a TM. Another vacuum cut. How often do I really use facade? Yeah. Maybe that was a bad idea, teaching facade. So let's make up for my mistake. Let's teach vacuum cut instead. Wait, yeah. Forget. Yeah. Yes. We will forget facade. Vacuum cut. Now we can hit all enemies in the room. And you know what? If this jinxes it and we suddenly don't have to do any more monster houses because now I'm prepared, they'll be like, ha, joke's on you. I hate monster houses. So, and I just realized, yeah, teaching Dinsai them isn't going to be all that helpful because Dinsai doesn't always get to get into the room. When we're doing those things, yeah. So, yeah, let's use Absorb on a Dragonite. Also, I always find it fascinating that we're fighting things like Dragonites and Garchomps and Manectrix and Magmortars. Lots of really powerful things. And we're an Eevee and a Mudkip. Or, you know, any low-level starter Pokemon, you know? I always find that weird. Or not weird, I find it cool. Yeah, I find it cool that we're killing all these big, powerful things, and Grovile, you now have to fight Bastiodon because you walked in that spot instead of Dinsai. But that's fine, it worked out. Oh, the stairs are right there, cool. Yay. All right, health? Yeah, I don't think we're gonna have time for, well, this is definitely not the final episode. I could squeeze all a Temporal Tower maybe into one episode. If I really wanted to. And this may be difficult. Never mind. That was a one shot. We can attack Tropius. Take this. And there's someone else there. It's a Manectric. Take this. Goodbye. Wow. Okay. We're doing good. We're actually destroying things. And a trap. Because why not? And Grovile's going to stop on it because he's a freaking idiot. That's the AI of this game. They don't know how to walk around a trap. They probably do with an AI skill or an IQ skill in the future. Will not step on traps. That's probably an IQ skill way down the line. So yeah, regardless of what we decide to do after this playthrough, I missed us. Good. I'm looking forward to being finished with this and putting it under my belt, because I did want to finish this. I really did. I just... 3 months of having to do other stuff, and, you know, this had to take the loss. I said the phrase before. I forgot what it was. Be the thing that I was doing that had to suffer. And we wind. That was a blowing trap. Special band. We already have a special band. It can't be that special. We already have one. So yeah. I think we're actually doing my favorite battle today. Oh, hello, Magmortar, standing right there in front of us. Nifty box, I don't care that much. What is this, TM? Recycle, no thanks. No thank you. Appreciate the offer, though. Actually, do I still have a plane seed? No, why would I have a plane seed? I haven't used a revival seed, do I? I'm going crazy here. I can't use an XI seed ever, though, so why don't I just swap that? Same with a stun seed. But at the same time, I'm never gonna open this box. So this is equally pointless. But it feels like it's more important, you know? It gives that feeling of unknown treasure and excitement and stuff. Or I guess. And there's nothing in here. Oh, you guys take care of it, please. Please. Thank you. Oh my god. Dinsai, you frickin' rock. Thank you. Yeah, you deserve an amazing level up. Okay, cool. Well, is my attack power still raised? From the swagger? That'd be pretty cool if it was. There's an enemy over there. Must be asleep because it's not chasing me. Another joy ribbon. No thanks. Proceed. Hello, Magmortar. Again. Mud slap. What's Dinsai's moves looking like? Oh wait, we healed just recently because of the halfway point. Never mind. We're doing fine for moves. Show me your moves. I guess another option for things I could do in between is not a playthrough, but bigger video creations like top tens and stuff. But at the same time, those take a while to make. And you know, so does Sunrise, which is the thing I'm currently spending most of my time doing. So, I don't know. I mean, technically it's an option. But, I don't know if it's a good option. Because I don't actually know how frequently those would get done. Wow, you lowered Dinsai's physical attack! Whatever will we do? And I don't care about that light box.
I only want dark boxes.
Rampart has picked up the light box. Oh, so there's something right behind us. Am I gonna kill Garchomp one more turn? Thank you. I need an Oran Berry anyway, though. Eat an Oran Berry. Thank you. Yay. Hello, I meant to stop walking. Crap. Because I did. Oh wow, he missed Fire Punch. I feel like I'm getting lucky with Magmortars missing their attacks. Hey, Stairs. I'm glad they're here and not the way that was going up from that other pathway. And what is this TM? Recycle. Why? Oh, because we hit an Oran Berry. That's why we could pick that up. Okay. I don't want that move, but what's this move? Light screen. Could that be helpful? Oh, wait. We have a used TM. That's the most worthless item possible. No, I don't want to go to light screen. That's fine. I don't know how helpful it is in Mystery Dungeon. I've never used it. So, I really like reflecting light screen in the main series. Especially for Nuzlocke, but I don't know how good they are here. Oh my god, I didn't mean to do that. I guess I'm used to having only two people, so I'm trying to do movements that I know would respond with Dinsai, or the result would be Dinsai doing a certain thing. But he's not doing those certain things because we have three people. So the AI is slightly different. And there's someone behind us and in front of us. Great. Okay. That's fine. Grovyle can take care of the Garchomp behind us, I'm guessing. I hope so, at least. Oh no, I've been taunted. Grovyle is not fighting anything behind us. Did he stop following us? He stopped following us. Oh no, we're poisoned and taunted. Good thing that happened right here. So yeah. Another idea for a new playthrough, I think I was saying this, is a Nuzlocke of a Pokemon game I've done already, but I feel like I've been having more fun doing those on live streams, not gonna lie. So I'd rather save them for those. Hey, wait! A roll call orb. Executive decision. I am allowed to use roll call orbs, like I've said. Like, I did... I'm not allowed to use orbs for my rules, but, roll call orbs help me just be more convenient and get out of monster houses. It's either that or more life, more pure seeds. What's the difference? They have the same result. And there were no monster houses in the Hidden Land. I'm very happy about that. Look at Alarme! The fantastic painting of the descriptions of the walls! Like Lapper said, this place is the old ruins. The Rainbow Stone Ship should be here. Yep, that's right. Let's go in there. What? What is this place? I'm not sure myself, but I would imagine. Must be the temple of the old ruins. Let's head up these stairs. 3 days later. That was a lot of stairs. This appears to be the top. Hey, look there. Oh, wait, that was... Didn't I say that? The strange pattern is here, too. There's a small indentation in the middle. I wonder what it's for. Gee, I wonder! This small... What is it, Lorame? It's a stone tablet. Seems something inscribed here. What are these? These strange runes. It's inscribed with unknown letters. It's written in ancient language. The ancient language of the unknown. Gee, that's so hard to read. Wow. Grovyle is so smart. I'm sorry, I think that's funny. I feel like I mentioned earlier that there's a language later that thing is a real language. It's just unknown letters. Whatever. I've got it! Here's the place itself is the Rainbow Stone Ship! What? This is it? Yep, that's right. There's an indentation here. Here it is. Dinsai. This is where it goes. Fit that fragment of the strange pattern to the indentation. You mean to put my Rayleigh fragment in there? That's right. That will activate the Rainbow Stone Ship. We can ride at the Temporal Tower. You know, I never realized how often Grovyle says, that's right. Like, he says that a lot. I feel like I've never taken note of that before. But, like, just re-looking through all his dialogue and just thinking about it, eh. That's quite enough of that! Who's there? It's Sableye! Ha ha ha! Dusknoir! How did you get here? Quite simple, actually. I had Master Yaga warp us here directly. After all, I knew that you would inevitably come here. Waiting here has spared us the bother of having to search for you. Erg. Hoo-hoo-ha! Unfortunately, you are coming back to the future with me. Sableye, take them to the dungeon hall! Weh-heh-heh! You know, now would be a great time to have a bite, now that I think about it. Hey! There's a dimensional hole! Sableye! Into the dimensional hole with them! Weh-heh-heh! Stinsai and Lorame. Yeah. Yes? I'm with ya! Gah! Well, well. You display some feeble resistance, knowing that it's futile. You expected anything less? Humph. You leave me no choice. I'll simply defeat you here, then take it to the future. Makes no difference to me. The odds are overwhelmingly stacked against you. How much resistance can you even serve up? Show me. Swarm them. Dusknoir. Do it. Alright. Dinsai, just use Water Pulse right now? Just use Water Pulse at this moment, because you'll shoot one of the Sableye. That'd be great. I am going to start with a helping hand, because I will do crap in this battle. I'm going to try to just buff them as much as possible. So let's use a helping hand. Okay, let's see what they do. I'm also going to be the team cleric, giving organ berries as needed. Or that one! That one works too! Alright, so clearly Water Pulse is Dinsai's best move. So I should have... I think it is, right? Let's just double check. We got time. Don't worry, it's a turn-based game. Water Pulse is 5-star power. Vacuum, or I could use Vacuum Cut. But it's a normal move, isn't it? Move, basic information. Where does it tell you the type of move? Move basic. Does it not tell you the, oh, type water special. Okay, hold on. It is type none? It has no type. Do it. Do it. I'm gonna do it. Vacuum cut. Okay, that actually didn't do as much damage as I would like. And that it lowered a stat? Oh. Use quick attack of all moves. Okay, that... I hate fairy swipes. Okay, so what did that do? What did that actually do? Did I not... I should have read the description. What does it do? Inflicts damage on all enemies in the room. Oh, the thing lowered was pressure. Okay, I thought a stat of mine was lowering. No, it was just from pressure. Okay. That actually wasn't as strong as I thought it would be. But I'm pretty sure all the Sableye will die if I use it one more time. Pretty sure. But, pretty sure. Me and Dinsai use it one more time. They should all die, right? They should. I'd be really upset if they don't. They didn't. Crap. Okay, I think we're gonna lose. Okay, that one's dead. That's good. Regular attack, mean look. That's okay. We don't need to run away. Okay. Grovyle's almost dead. I need to heal him. We're gonna use a Oran Berry on him. Oh, I just thought of something. Okay, never mind. Dead. 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 Gotcha. Dig. Bye. Okay. Go back to Water Pulse. And, have an Oran buried inside. Team Cleric. That's what I am right now. 140 damage! Yeah, do it! Look at all that damage! That's a lot of damage! That's not that much damage, Lorme. Boom! Done! Goodbye, Dusknoir! Screw you! That was my favorite battle of the game, by the way. I love killing Dusknoir. It's so satisfying! I refuse to lose! Ugh. I'm so foolhardy. You dare to challenge me? For all the effort in the world, with your puny power, you had no chance of winning from the start. Dusknoir is truly tough, but we won. Don't give up, there's a way out of this. That's easy for you to say. Humph, you've done admirably well for those as pitiful as you, but it's all over now. This is the end. The mouth and his stomach, it's open up. He's gonna do something. What do you need to do? Barf at us directly from the stomach acid in his stomach? Wait a second. The mouth on his stomach. That's it. This could work. What is it, Lorme? What do you think? Attack the big black ball! Combine our power to attack the big black ball. Whoa, my stomach! And I don't know how we determined that was his weak spot. I don't know. Yeah, we did it. Is Dusknoir is down. We finally beaten Dusknoir. Wait, it can't be. Wait, Lord Dusknoir. Lord Dusknoir was defeated? Uh-oh. Where? Our whole meaning in life is gone! Humph, your Sableye ran off. You just have no luck attracting reliable allies. Dinsai, what is it? Go to the top of the temple. Put the relic from it in that hollow spot. I want you to check on the rainbow so much it actually works. You know, Lorme and I will keep an eye on Dusknoir here. Okay, I'll go do that. La 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 la. The rainbow torch works. We can go to Temporal Tower. I hope it activates. Don't move! Grovyle, Lorme, is this what you really want? If history is changed, we Pokemon of the future will disappear. What? History has changed. Boy, will the future will disappear? It won't be just me. Both of you. Grovyle and Lormite alike. So you come from a future that will cease to exist. You will disappear both. You both will disappear. Is that what you really want? If we change history, we'll disappear too? Is Dusknoir... Dusknoir telling the truth? Grovyle! It's true, Lorime. If we change history, we will disappear. Because, you know, we change time. Time goes differently. We won't be born. But that doesn't matter. If it means restoring time and bringing peace to the world, it's what I came to the past to do. Celebi, too. She helped us, knowing that she will disappear if we succeed. Even Celebi? Oh, I recall her in the future. If we were so kind of friends, we'd all be spared the agony of the world of darkness. That's what she meant. So instead that stole her whole life, this is what she meant. And Lorime, you came with that same resolve. We came from the future fully accepting what would happen to us. But the way you are now, you don't remember that resolve. I know this is coming as a great shock to you, but we have no choice in the matter either way. If we don't act, time will be destroyed. The planet's paralysis will begin. To bring peace to this world, we have to disappear. To try to understand that, Lorime. So that's all it was. I came to this world with such a resolve, knowing that if we succeeded, we would disappear. But if we don't act, the destruction of time can't be stopped. That means we have to do it. Even that means I must disappear. Oh, Lorime, but there's just one thing. One thing changed for us by coming to this world. It's true that we had to resolve to complete our mission. That was true we first came back to this world. But we had nothing to lose and nothing to go back to. But Lorime, that change will be becoming Pokemon. You found a friend and partner in Dinsai. Dinsai looks up to you. If your partner found out that you might disappear, I'm sure Dinsai would be crushed. Dinsai has a good spirit, but the future is altered, and if the future is altered and you disappear, your partner will... Dinsai will be left all alone. I finally understand. If I change history, I will disappear. If I disappear, Dinsai will... Really? Yes, I like saving my adventure. Thank you very much for asking. We're not... I know it's a little over my normal time of episode, but no, we're not done with this cutscene yet. I'm not sure why it asked me to save there, to be quite honest. Here it is. It's the hollow spot. The relic fragment is supposed to go in this spot. It'll activate the Roma Stainship. Grovyle said it's worth a try. You place it in the spot. Swing! Ah, it moved! It moved! Guys, it moved! It's working! What was that? Dinsai's done it! That noise, it has to be the sound of the Rainbow Steel Shift activating! I won't! You'll never change history! Grovyle! So you shielded Lorime, Grovyle? That's taking a heavy toll on you! Very well, you're going down first! What are you doing? Dusknoir! I'm taking you with me! We're going back to the future!
What?
Lorime, it's up to you now! I just pooped out the time gears! Okay, team! The Rainbow Stone Ship's all set to go. Come on, let's go!
Oh, wait, what's going on? What's going on, guys?
Dinsai, this is it for me. I'm taking Dusknoir back to the future.
Huh? What? What are you doing?
I can never come back here again. Watch Lorime's back. Promise me.
But take your place, Grovyle. I can't.
You must and you will. Because you can, Dinsai. You two are the greatest of combinations. Well, unhand me. Release me. We're almost there. Quiet. Shut up. We're having a conversation here, Dusknoir. Lorime. Take care, Lorime. I was lucky to have known you. Though the parting hurts, the rest is in your hands.
Grovyle!
Sorry for the holdup, Dusknoir! Now we'll get back to pushing with the portal!
Grovyle, why?
The Silent Rainbow Stone Ship! It's getting louder! The Rainbow Stone Ship, it looks like it's ready to go!
But, Grovyle... It's sad. I'm too sad to even move. But Right. If we don't hurry, we won't. The Rambo ship might go without us, and then this whole thing would be like that would be the lamest way to fail the adventure, wouldn't it? If we don't make it back, the stone ship flew away. Whoops. Well, I guess we can't put the time gears back now. We better go. The time gears. I'd better gather them up. How am I gonna hold these in my pocket? Whatever. Stop the planet's paralysis. We'll change the future to a better world. A world in which Grovyle can live happily. No, that's not how it's gonna work, Dinsai. But maybe we should we shouldn't tell him. No, we just saw this cut. We don't need to flashback to this, but okay. That's right. The future's changed, Grovyle will disappear. And I will disappear too. Hey, Lorimei. The last thing Grovyle said to you, Lorimei. Yeah. Parting hurts, the rest in your hands. Yes, we heard that, yes. His last words, parting hurts. I understand that feeling. I understand how it hurts. Grovyle was partners with you for a long time, Lorimei. I think it must have hurt Grovyle terribly to leave you. That may be what he meant, but no, that isn't it. Grovyle's last words, they weren't about me and Grovyle. He meant me and Dinsai. Grovyle said what he did because he knew that I would have to leave Dinsai eventually. When history is changed, I will disappear. My time with Dinsai is ending. This is our last adventure. Hey, Lorimei! We have to do this for Grovyle's sake! Let's go to Temporal Tower! Let's do it! Final chapter. The last adventure. Wow. What a fitting name for the final chapter. You guys couldn't have been coming up with anything a little bit more subtle than that. What? It's getting louder! We better get on right now! Wow. Just in time. Wow, wow, wow! Zoom. Wow. It is. Now I see where the rainbow part comes in. Hey, look at that! It's Temporal Tower! Finally, we're on our way. We're going there. Hey, I didn't use a single freaking Reviver Seed. I'm impressed with myself. I did not expect that. To be fair, I didn't run into any monster houses. I feel like if I did, and I'm also unimpressed with Vacuum Cut, not gonna lie. There's no turning back now. Hey, up there! The top of Temporal Tower is glowing red. What could that be?
It's the power of darkness.
Well, here we are. This is the entrance to Temporal Tower. The ground's shaking! Did it settle down? What was that tremor anyway? Hey, that reminds me. Grovyle once said something about this. The time started going out of control because Temporal Tower began collapsing. That tremor we just felt. Temporal Tower will be collapsing as we speak. We have to hurry, Lorimei. All right. That's that. Tune in for the last episode coming up next. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you all for the final episode where we climb Temporal Tower and face Dialga. See you then. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And rock on.